Добрый день. Good afternoon. Сегодня у нас accusative case. Today we have accusative case. What does it mean, case? Case. The thing is that in some sentences, when we have objects, we have to change the end of the object. We have the same thing in all European languages, in English the same. Sentences like, I look at something, and then comes the object, then I am waiting for, then comes the object, or the page of the book, yes, something like that, the name of the book, so the preposition. In Russian we have fewer prepositions, but we have six cases, and accusative case is the most common of them. So we see it, we can face it in sentences when we have subject, then we have verb, and then we have object. Yes, like I see something, I know something, I have something. Do you remember we had a lesson on have, and there was an example of that? I will put a link to that lesson below the video. So, and what do we have in English? We have some sentences like, I put them already in Russian. Anna смотрит на фотографию. Anna looks at the photo. Photo is фотография. Фотография. In our accusative case sentence, we change it into фотографию. Фотографию. We change the ending of the object. Then, папа ждет друга. My father is waiting for his friend. Друг, friend, is the object here. And we put R, we change the end of this word. Then comes, я слушаю песню. I'm listening to the song. Песня, song. We change it into песню. Yes, like that. So, how to remember all these endings? Actually, that depends on the gender, plural or singular, things like that. But you will never start speaking Russian if you will start thinking logically what gender it is, neutral or no, maybe it is masculine or something like that. It is too difficult. So, what we do with my students is that we drill these endings, and usually it takes about one, two lessons, sometimes three lessons. And usually after that hard drilling, yes, we are able to feel comfortable with these endings. We put them automatically, yes? And now we are going to practice that together. So, we have some objects. Фотография, друг, песня. Let's have a look. How we change the endings. So the word ending, if we have animate object ending with a consonant, for example, student, student, what do? We add a, it comes to studenta, student, studenta. Let's take this phrase, я вижу, I see. So, how to say I see a student? We have to say я вижу студента. Yes? Я вижу студента. It works only with animate. If it is inanimate, for example, palace, дворец, we don't change it. It stays the same. Я вижу, I see, дворец. I see a palace. Я вижу дворец. Yeah? Get it? Got it? Okay. Then, if the word ends with e, it's not e because of that mark. So that is why it is e. Actually, it's a consonant. For example, the word герой. E changes into я. It makes героя. So how to say I see a hero? Я вижу героя. Okay, then, if our word ends with soft sign, soft sign, and it is animate. It is animate. So, for example, the word teacher, учитель, учитель. We change soft sign into я. So how to say I see a teacher? Я вижу учителя. Yes? Hope it's not very difficult. Actually, you understand that it takes only practice. Yes, there is nothing super complicated about that. Yes, but it takes practice. It takes practice. Drilling, 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 repeating it many, many, many times. Yes? Okay. Then we come to word endings A and Я. A, like in the word актриса, actress, актриса, changes into У. I see an actress. Я вижу актрису. Yeah? And the last one, Я, changes into You. You. Неделя, week. Неделя will become неделю. It makes no sense if we say I see a week, я вижу неделю. But let's take I'm waiting. Yes, in Russian there is no difference between I'm waiting and I wait. We say only я жду. Yes, there is only one present tense that makes our life easier. So, я жду неделю. Yes, I'm waiting for a week. Я жду неделю. Okay? So, that is practically all. Yes? So, how to work with it? You can actually practice it alone. Take some objects. Yes, different objects. We have here дворец, palace, дом, house, гора, mountain, деревня, village, бабушка, granny, стол, table, берег, coast, поле, field, кошка, a cat, a female cat. Then you take some verbs. We already took я вижу, I see, я слышу, I hear, я знаю, I know, я жду, I wait, or I'm waiting. That would be more natural to say I'm waiting. Я жду на русском. And then you make, let's take for example two. Я вижу, я слышу. And then you take four or five objects. Yes? So you, how to say I see a mountain. Я вижу. Then you find A. Yes? It changes into U. Я вижу гору. Я вижу гору. If, for example, we face something that is not here, so we don't change it. For example, the word field, поле. We have nothing here, so we don't change it. There will be я вижу поле. I see a field. Yes? Usually it takes not more than three lessons, usually two, sometimes even one, to practice it thoroughly. That is the key point here, to practice it thoroughly. If you need my help, or if you want my help in any other issue related to learning Russian, you know what to do, yes? We can always have Skype lessons. Then please, if you find this useful, you can always subscribe, like, share my video, and ask anything in the comment section. It was very nice meeting you today. Have a nice day. Хорошего дня.